I was born not far from here, about 10-15 miles that way, in the south of the city. And I used to say I was born in a cold winter near the Russian border. Well, the Russian border is somehow that way, some 600 miles maybe. We'll have to check on the updates, because the Russians move in mysterious ways, as you know. Putin in the first place said there's nobody, no Russian in the Crimea or eastern part of Ukraine, but we all know that Crimea is no part of Russia, not recognized by the international world, except for, who knows, the crazies in Venezuela and such places. But still, it's under Russian and the Russian occupation. So the Red Russians, the Soviets, have impacted all my life. Even though I have three Borzoi, Russian hounds, inside. There used to be five, but that's my spouse. She had this terrible desire to actually at one point fill the house with puppies. We had a series of 12 and then another of 11, and they were gone with very great pains, because people don't, they're not so popular, they're rare and interesting. People are not so keen on them, even if they come free. But that's maybe part 55 or so of this little story. The Russians had also, apart from this, an impact, an influence in terms of thinking, for what it's worth. Dostoevsky, Tolstoy have influenced my adolescent years, when I was reading Crime and Punishment and other novels in the kitchen. We only had two rooms. No, that's not two bedrooms for those who think in those terms. It's just two rooms. And in one, I had to sleep with my father in the same bed. And in the other, my sister was sharing with my mother. The same tiny place. That changed, of course, after a while. Now there's how things change. There's a big house. Too big, actually. And never been in the attic for the last couple of years, I guess. But back then, in order to rule the night, there was no other way. I had to go to the balcony, there was a balcony, and jump in the kitchen to read at candlelight, because my father disagreed with this intense, too much reading, as you call it. He was a nice guy. I would say that I got along excellently with him for most of the time. True, he died quite young, when he was 49. So at about 20 I was without a father. And with my mother, relations have been tense, not exactly the Sopranos, Tony and his mother relationship, but about that. At times, at least. My father was a man with many stories of his own. I remember now one when he in the army, in order to avoid the hard tasks. Those were stupid days under communism, when the army was taken out to dig wells, all kinds of stupid and heavy duty to raise, to collect the crops, to all kinds of things, sometimes to bury the crops, because they were so stupid and irresponsible, criminal, obviously. Communist regime is a terror, a dictatorship and a criminal regime, no matter what leftists would say, and the stupid guys who wear Che Guevara t-shirts. They don't know nothing about the principles. What principles and ideas behind those lefties and the crimes they committed against humanity. Stalin, Mao and the rest have killed many times more than Hitler, who was no small criminal. But getting back to my father and his story, in order to avoid the stupid hard tasks of the APV, Armata pe Viață, he tried all kinds of tricks. Once he agreed with a guy who was experimenting with sewing ears to the head. He said their ears are too far from the head, which was not right. Let me make a, like an aesthetic surgery. So he brought the ears closer to the head for my father. That was one. And another time he pretended he knows about projecting films on the screen, but he didn't know. So when he started projecting the film, it was upside down, and some other tricks. Which reminds me of something with my mother's family, her twin brother and others. They went to the cinema for the first time, and the seats were not, they were unfolded when the public came in, and the audience needed to take them down from the vertical position. But the twin brother of my mother, oh well, same name as my father, was just walking around because he didn't know how to do this, so he had to be told to unfold this. And once the film started, they had something like an introduction with current events, and he again jumped on his feet. Look, bunicul, iată regele vine spre noi, King Michael's coming to us. He was new and he didn't know. He had the impression that indeed the king would come and join the audience from the screen, something like that. Well, we'll have a next episode, inshallah, soon. Bye-bye.